Hello and welcome to the next video in my project Maelstrom's view collection. This is just Lunacina, aka JJ Maelstrom. Now I would like to do something special for my 30th video, and I would like to talk about the event that changed my generation's life. Every generation has that one event in history that changes their lives and changes world history as we know it. My grandparents' day days of change were the bombing of Pearl Harbor and D-Day. Both events occurred in World War II. My parents' generation of event was when John F. Kennedy was assassinated, and everybody can remember where they were on that day. And same goes for my grandparents' generation too. I would like to talk about the 9/11 attacks in 2001. Now, I was a 16-year-old teenager who went to Margaretville Central School in Upstate, New York. About maybe 3.5 hours from New York City. About 4 out of 5 given the traffic conditions and all that. Now, it was a typical September day. School just started like a week beforehand, and nobody really wanted to go to school at all. It was tiring, we were all cranky, we were also talking about some vacation, how much we didn't want to go to school for the entire year. Your typical teen stuff. Boys, girls, whatever we were thinking about. We wanted to go out to school at the moment. We went to my first period class, which was in the art room, which was right next to the cafeteria. We all were kindergartners and first graders, maybe even second grade, I think. Outside, it was construction being done on the school, and everything was going pretty smoothly. You know, my art teacher was nice. I think his name was Tom Rappin, and he was a nice guy, very nice. I forgot what project working on, but it was a fairly simple thing to do. Construction outside was going smoothly. You could hear all the buzzing and all the construction tools and everything going good. The weather was pretty nice. A little bit on the tree side, but that's beside the point. It was still pretty nice day out. Then sometime during the mid period, somebody turned the TV on from outside the classroom, and that's what we realized, that something bad was happening. Something really bad and horrible was happening in New York City. I will not be showing any footage of it because that'd be way too dramatic for anybody, even me, living far away from it. But what I will say is that I was very, very heartbroken by what happened. And that let me give us a moment of silence for all the people who perished on that day. Now, I was actually worried about one individual, my Uncle Benny, Benjamin Lencina. And, the reason why I was worried that he was affected by what happened at what they call Ground Zero now, is because he was a banker, and I'm not sure if he was a banker at the time, but he still worked with finances, and it worried me because, you know, down in New York City, that was the financial district, so I thought that he was affected by it. Thank goodness that he wasn't, though. And, during the entire day, I was worried about him. Now, people were worried about it. Excuse me. And people were sudden and stricken. Everyone outside the room, you know, even the little kids outside were quiet. And that doesn't happen very often with a room full of kindergartners and young children. But it was quiet. Okay? Now, when it happened, you know, they kept repeating the footage over and over again to hope. Somebody said, do you think that anything like that will happen? Well, we are, Floyd Vincent, Margaret Villain, Andy, and the high R. So people were saying, no, I don't think it will happen like that. Nothing bad will happen. It was only later on that I found out about flight number 77 that crashed into the Pentagon, and flight number 93 that unfortunately all the passengers perished in that attempt. But thank goodness though that they were able to thwart the terrorist plan of, of whatever they were planning to do. Now, there was way too much of the hatred. But one thing I am glad for on 9/11 is that everybody banded together to help others out, regardless of race, religion, creed, or overall personality. They helped out. They provide assistance for the elderly, for everybody affected in the area. And one day when I get the chance, it's nice out, I will take footage from the tallest tower in New York City. Well, the second largest tower. And I will make sure to get a nice clear picture of the tallest city in America. The tallest tower in one of the biggest cities in the world. The Freedom Tower. Just to show that there ain't nobody that can destroy the freedom in New York City or in America. And I salute all the people, all the men and women who hunt down and who hunted down all the animals who perpetuated this horrific attack on America. You have my respect. Now, I would like to play a song that encapsulates all the feelings of Americans. Before, during, and after the 9/11 attacks,
if tomorrow things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again, just my children and my wife. Thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and we can't take that away. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, from New York to LA, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time to stand and say,
now, wouldn't we agree that that song is awesome? It has specific, good things associated with me, because back when I was a little kid, in one program they used to call it, they used to play a song sometimes, and everyone in the classroom would stand up and sing with it. So, God bless everyone in America and the world. If you want, you can make comments in the comment box for your own stories of what happened. You know, what happened, where you were during the 9/11 attacks. If you should choose, I know it's not the best topic to bring up or the best one to talk about or discuss, but it's good to have a collection of these type of stories. So, I'd like to say I thank you for watching my video on these horrific events. And, please enjoy my other videos. And remember, God bless America and all of our troops. Have a good day now.